Hello, sweeties. Welcome to Astrology with Linda Shaw. Do not forget to subscribe and share, which is a huge drag, I know. And if you want to be reminded about upcoming episodes, press that little bell thing after you've subscribed and then they'll let you know. Now, let's take a look at the week ahead. That's November 11, 2018. The planets are about to sort themselves out a bit. Love and money get fixed on Thursday, more or less. But communications go bananas on Friday, which is ridiculous, really. So although the opportunities are better, misunderstandings are almost guaranteed. We can't win. But we try, and we're going to trust our instincts for a while. That's enough of that. Let's get to the stars. Scorpio, my love, in another life, you could have been a detective. Or even in this life, you know, go for it. You're so good at figuring out what's really going on behind the bullshit, you even surprise yourself. This week, you're getting the job done and unearthing the game players, which doesn't make you all that popular with the dodgy guys. But the bosses are all singing your praises. You're wondering about the merits of being a whistleblower. Never mind them. Do what feels right. You have fantastic instincts and you're learning and growing into an extraordinary human being. Maybe even a god. You never know. That's for Scorpio. Sagittarius, darling, you're not just shooting yourself in the foot. No, no. You're actually putting the bullet straight in your head. What is wrong with you? Okay, this is enough of this. It's time to sort out your life. Just because you were born lucky and everyone loves you doesn't mean you're not required to make the occasional effort. This is the week for that. So stand up, look around, and do what has to be done. And don't even think about asking what that is, because you know perfectly well what you need to do to fix your life. Your talents are endless. Your instincts are superb. Don't worry about friends or lovers this week. This week is about you. Fix your life. If you do it right, you'll be smiling by Friday. That's it for Sagittarius. Capricorn, my darling, once you go ahead with your plans, everything will look so much easier, especially at work. For now, there's no need to take anyone else into account. They can bloody well look after themselves this week. You have the chance to do something you've wanted to do for ages and didn't have the balls. You've just grown up here, big enough to absorb everyone's complaints and to carry on regardless. Marvelous stuff. Of course, the personal life should theoretically be improving, but probably won't. One nutty planet has just been replaced by another, bringing confusion all round. Forget that for now. Let yourself be fabulously powerful. It'll be a good week. That's it for Capricorn. Aquarius, old bean. Just because you're perfectly happy getting on with your own thing doesn't mean that's what you'll be doing. Your universe needs you. And amazingly, when you get your head out of your ass, you're a brilliant natural leader. The world is changing, and you're the one showing the others how to change with it. In fact, you're probably the only one who's excited at the prospect of all the new adventures. Everyone else is shitting themselves. So get out there and help. Take your friends along for the ride. You can play next week. This week, the planets are shifting and confusion reigns. If you need help or a bigger budget, ask. No, insist. You'll get whatever you need. That's it for Aquarius. Pisces, my sweetie. There are obviously some things you really hate doing. So you procrastinate, driving yourself crazy with guilt until it's almost too late. Then, of course, you labor over each tiny detail until it really is too late. This is a pattern that doesn't serve you that well. And although this may not be the easiest week to change your personal brand of weirdness, it's an excellent time to start. The planets are shifting and the universe is turning on its head. How about creating a new you? An efficient you, a you without guilt, a you that does stuff when it actually needs to be done. There's not much else going on now anyway, except maybe the twinklings of a new love. But more on that later. Meanwhile, make some lists, short ones. Start there. That's it for Pisces. Aries, my sweet. The career is shifting and you'll need to educate yourself if you're hoping to keep up. The planets aren't exactly on your side at the moment, but then they're not really on anybody's. Still, there could be power trips from people who'll help you, but only if you're willing to grovel a little. Just remember, ego is very boring when it stops you being happy. Besides, There are some things, amazingly, you're just not able to control, no matter how fabulous you obviously are. It's a shock, I know. And your personal life? Well, the less said about that, the better. Just try and behave. Stay home on the nights when you're feeling particularly wicked. That's it for Aries. Taurus babe, your personal planet is about to fix up her hair and get back where she belongs. Sighs of relief all round. This has been an absolute nightmare for you. You've had to figure out all your own moves without the slightest hint of a role model. Anyway, she's back. Yay. Needless to say, there'll be a few other dramas to deal with. The upcoming communication problem being the biggest. But you'll cope with that later for that. The most important thing is that you're back in your own saddle and your love life is about to swing into some serious action. Don't worry about the career right now. It's in stagnation mode anyway, doing or rather not doing its own thing. Hold on to your pennies for now and open your heart to love. There's lots of it about. That's it for Taurus. Gemini, sweetie, you're about to have some serious fun. Just for a while, you get to do madly important things, enjoying yourself as you go. This doesn't happen often, so get up early and eat your Wheaties. You'll need to be really strong for this stuff. You may need some help, so stay charming even when it seems impossible. The communication planet is about to take a left turn on Saturday, actually, so get in while you can. Round up a team of supporters. In short, if you have a business or you're starting one, now's your chance to take it to the next level. If you've invented something or written a fabulous book, do the next thing. Whatever you're busy with, it's about to take off. Comb your hair nicely. That's it for Gemini. Cancer, my love, take a breath. You're getting all caught up in everyone else's crap and losing focus on your own life. Enough of that. Sure, help if you can and if you really want to, but martyrdom is out. You do not need to sacrifice your own life to make way for someone else's. There's actually plenty of space for everyone, no matter what the newspapers tell us. True, there won't be much time for a personal life this week, but that might actually come as a relief. You need to get your ducks in a row. They've all waddled off in different directions, and your health is suffering. Honestly, sit down, make some tea, breathe in and out. The world can amazingly cope without you for 5 minutes. Now, get back to work. Excellent. That's it for Cancer. Leo, you delicious creature. Pay very close attention to what's going on around you. Brilliant new ideas are popping out of that massive cranium, inspired by the people around and everything you see. There's so much going on now, and the others are missing it. It's up to you to find the creative source and breathe life into the moments. There's no point hiding your light under bushels, whatever bushels are, because the sparks are still visible to anyone who's looking. There's stuff happening now. Stop buggering around and combing your hair. Take a different route. Make a new plan. The universe is opening up to any of you who are prepared to get off your ass and take a chance. That means you. That's it for Leo. Virgo, my sweetie. This week, we're staying focused on the good stuff. Just for a few days, ignore the drama in everyone else's life and give yourself some real attention. Your planet is about to take a 3-week dive, next Saturday to be precise, so you'll need to be ready. Get some sleep, eat your veggies. Most importantly, tune into those fantastic instincts. The intellect loses focus when the communication planet is out of sync, so you'll need to rely on your instincts, which means trusting yourself. So this week, you'll be thinking about all the things that make you love yourself. Call on all your gifts. Tell everyone to be specially nice to you. You're the one who'll be bailing them out when the shit hits the fan next week. So for now, they get to look after you. That's it for Virgo. Libra, my darling, there are consequences to every move you make, as you very well know. Sure, some of them are fantastic and just what you wanted, but mostly you're being wrapped over the knuckles and told to behave. This is the last of a 6-week nightmare that's dragged you through every single room in the Heartbreak Hotel. By Saturday, though, you'll be packing those bags and leaving for happier climes, which means love, your favorite, will be possible again next week. For now, grit your teeth, protect your heart, don't listen to anyone's mad promises to love you forever. They're all nuttier than you are. By Saturday, your instincts will be back on track and we can speak again. You'll be fine. That's it for Libra. Thank you, fabulous creatures, for listening to Astrology with Linda Shaw. If you'd like to subscribe, just press the button, it's free. And if you want reminders, press that little bell thing and you'll be notified. If you have a question, tweet me on Ask Linda Shaw. I'll do my very best to answer. Take care of your gorgeous selves, and I'll see you next week. Bye for now.